Ruiz, the women's winner in the Boston Marathon today with a time of 2:31 and change. Now, we don't know how many seconds that is. It may be a new American record. What was the time in your first ever marathon, and where was it?
It was 2 hours and 56 minutes and 33 seconds in New York last year.
And so you improved from 2 hours and 56 minutes to 2 hours and 31 minutes. What do you attribute that improvement in time to?
Rosie Ruiz wins the Boston Marathon. Woohoo! Oh, and also, Joe Biden won the 2020 election. So what's the difference between these two incidences? Well, the big thing is, let me tell you, the media, the attitude of the media. With Rosie Ruiz, her story started falling apart almost immediately, and the skeptical media checked into it. They saw, for example, during the interview with her, Rosie Ruiz didn't even seem to know what interval exercises were. The interviewer expressed skepticism that she could go, her improved time in a Boston Marathon in 1980 was 25 minutes faster than her 1979 marathon in New York, which, by the way, it turned out she didn't actually finish that marathon. She had injured her ankle. Also, her form was just not that of a really professional runner. And on top of that is when you're done running at the end of the race, you're all exhausted and sweating. She didn't show any of those symptoms of exhaustion at all, really, just a little bit. So they started checking into her, the press, they actually were doing their job. They found out that she cut in. She actually only ran like the last mile, less than the last mile of the race. She cut in from the outside of the crowd and then entered the race. So her story fell apart very quickly, and the media were very skeptical right from the get-go, and they checked it out, it was done. Contrast that with what's going on now with the media. Now, imagine the attitude now, the cover-up mode of the media now had been applied back in 1980. Can you imagine? The media would be saying, how dare you be a marathon denier? Of course Rosie won, just shut up about it, accept that she won, and don't deny the reality of that. That's the difference. That's a big difference. And the media would be opposed to it. Shut up. Don't look on any videos or anything about where she entered a race. Hey, and so what? So she didn't know what interval exercises were. And just don't even investigate about whether she even finished the New York Marathon. That's over. It's over. Rosie Ruiz is the winner of the Boston Marathon. That's it. Accepted. That's the exact same attitude they have now with Joe Biden. They want you. And they're so angry about it. They're so angry. You just ask some questions. Just shut up and accept the results. So there's a big difference between a Rosie Ruiz marathon of 1980 and the Rosie Ruiz election of 2020. Now, here's the thing. If the press was so supremely confident, like, of course Joe Biden won, of course, you know what they would be doing right now? They would be going, hey, you stupid right-wing idiots, of course he won. And you know what? The best way to check, go audit the ballots, see for yourself. Go into the stats, check it out, and that'll prove that Joe Biden, no, instead, they're doing everything. They don't want you. In fact, if you even say that you want to do it, they get angry. You don't accept the results of the election. So that's the big difference that we had between Rosie Ruiz and, oh, by the way, one other difference. I bet you not even one in 100 of you even remember who the real winner of the 1980 marathon was, finally declared to be. In fact, I'll be honest with you, I looked it up about an hour ago, and you know what? I've already forgotten her name. But that's the big difference, because we will never forget the name of the winner by a landslide of the 2020 election, who is Donald John Trump. See you later.
I'm going to release the Kraken. I'm going to release the Kraken. I'm going to release the Kraken.